In this demo, I'd like to show you two ways of creating a brand new Java program. Let's say you've got to start a new project or maybe a new homework assignment. One of the things that sometimes confuses new programmers is how to get started on that process. I want to show you a default way by creating a new program from scratch in JGrasp, and then a more efficient way using the template that you've probably been setting up in a current or recent homework assignment. Let's take a look. So to create a new Java file from scratch, let's assume that we're in some empty working directory. Mine is called Java Working Directory, but yours can be whatever. This is on my desktop. And I'll open up my JGrasp and notice that we can navigate to this directory using the up arrow and this browser pane. So what we want to do now is go to the File menu and select New Java. And what we have now is an empty new Java file. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create the outer level class shell. So we're going to do public class, let's just call this my new Java class. And this is a block, so we'll have an opening and a closing curly brace, and we'll put those in there right away. And then every standalone method must have a main method. So let's add that inside this outermost class shell. So notice that I've indented by a standard 4 spaces, and this will be public static void main, opening curly brace, closing curly brace, and then inside the main method I'm going to add string bracket bracket args, and at this point we should have a working empty Java class. We can save this, and it's automatically going to save it to the right class file. And I should be able to compile this and run it, but notice that nothing happens. So inside of the main method, this is where the guts of my program is going to go. And just to make sure we're actually running this, I'm going to indent another 4 spaces. And I'm going to add a simple print statement. System.out.println is what we're going to use. And I'm just going to print some text. This is where my program goes. Closing double quotes, closing parentheses, terminating semicolon. I'll remove that extra space. And again, I'll save it, compile it, and run it. And this program works just fine. Let's also add, just for grins, let's add a variable declaration and initialization, and we'll print that out. Let's say int new var equals 100, and let's print that out as well with the system.out.println, and I can just do the name of the variable, and I should be able to save this, compile the changes, and run it once again. And notice that I've got the correct value, but remember we said that we should never make printouts like this. We should always have some sort of identifying label for the data. So let's add to our print statement something like new var equals, and this is string concatenation, and we will again save our changes, compile them, and run this. So we have a simple working program, and we can add the guts of our program inside this main method, but notice that there are some steps done here that will be common to all programs. We've got an outer class. Inside of that, we have a main method, and we have certain standard sections that we'll have in the code. Is there a better way of doing this? Well, of course there's a better way, and we can use the template that we've already developed for this purpose. So let's go ahead and we'll clear the output window, and let's close this file and go back to our working directory. So in this working directory, I'm going to copy over the template that I've created, and I'm going to copy it to a new file, and I'm going to rename that to, let's say, my next Java class. Then I'm going to open it up in JGrasp. And here is my template. And what I want to do now is I want to compile and run this. But notice that I can't compile it. And what this is telling me is that the name of this file name and the name of the contained class have to match exactly. So what I'll do is I'll select this text and I'll do a find and replace, and I will change it to my next Java class as it's expecting, and I'll do a replace all. And notice that I changed it both here in the file name and in the class name. So if I save this now, I should be able to compile it and run it successfully, even though it doesn't do anything. So let's take a look at this standard structure. Notice that now we've got the required header, and we've got the general structure of any class, and we have the pseudocode sections for the various parts of our file. So what I can do now is use this as my starting point. And just to make sure that this works, let's add a simple print statement, system.out.println. My code output goes here, closing brace. Let's, for example, let's declare an integer variable similar to what we did last time. Actually, I'll do this in two stages. I'll declare it, and I will separately initialize it to some value, and we will print it out in the same way as before using println, and I'll make sure I give it a label this time, int var equals, and then the name of the variable, and I should be able to save and run this. And there we go. There's my outputs. So notice what we did. We used our template to good advantage here to help us avoid having to write all this stuff from scratch. Once we copy this over and update the name of the class in both places, we can just fill in the things that are specific to the new program that we're working on. There's no point in creating this header all over again. There's no point in creating this class and the public static void main over again. Let's just be smart about it and use our template. So I would encourage you, when you're doing all of your coming programs, to use your template in this way to get you started quicker. So I hope that's been of some help in helping you get started on a new program.